Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. So in this video, I will bring to you the best multiple choice questions from the month of May. 200 I have selected, 200 questions out of the 1000 odd that I cover in my weekly videos. This video will be very, very useful for the upcoming exams. Now, if you want to buy our any of the course, we have some of the finest courses available. These are all self-preparatory courses and the syllabus is covered in the form of videos. We have courses for SSC Bank PO, UPSC, NABARD, and various other exam. If you want to buy any of the course, then go to studyiq.com. Do connect with me on Instagram. I come online two times. I come live two times a day and answer your queries. If you want to talk to me, please connect with me. Tireless Soul is my ID. So I'm on Twitter also, and my ID is Gauravgarh888. Who has been sworn in as the first woman advocate to directly become a judge of the Supreme Court? Please note that the Chief Justice of India is Deepak Mishra. And Deepak Mishra is the 45th Chief Justice. And he will now be replaced by Justice Ranjan Gogoi. Justice Gogoi will become the 46th Chief Justice of India. And remember that the senior most judge of the Supreme Court becomes the Chief Justice. The first woman advocate to directly become a judge is Indu Malhotra. Also remember, the judge of the Uttarakhand High Court, K.L. Joseph, he will also be raised, elevated to the level of the judge of the Supreme Court. And these are two more appointments that you need to know. Punjab Haryana High Court, the new Chief Justice is Justice Ajay Kumar Mittal. These are Chief Justice appointments. And Manipur High Court, new Chief Justice is Justice Ramalingam Sudhakar. Also, Manipur was in news because of one more reason. There is a village called Lisang Village. It is in Senapati district of Manipur. And Lisang Village has become the last village in India to get electrified. When was the International Chernobyl Disaster Remembrance Day observed? Chernobyl is basically a place in Ukraine, and there was a nuclear mishap here which affected more than 8.4 million people, and this took place on 26th of April 1986. So this is called Chernobyl disaster, and for those people who got affected, we celebrate International Chernobyl Disaster Remembrance Day. These are some of the other days in the month of May and the last week of April that you need to remember. 25th April was the World Malaria Day, and the theme was Ready to Beat Malaria. Then 26th April was the International Chernobyl Disaster Remembrance Day. 26th April was also the day World Intellectual Property Day, and the theme is Powering Change, Women in Innovation and Creativity. 28th April was World Day for Safety and Health at Work. There are a lot of diseases which are called occupational disease. So the theme was Occupational Safety Health, Vulnerability of Young Workers. 29th April was the International Dance Day. 30th April was Vesak Day. This is related to Buddhism. 30th April was the International Jazz Day. 1st May, Labor Day. 1st May was also the World Asthma Day. And the theme was Never Too Early, Never Too Late. It's always the right time to address the airway disease. 2nd May was the World Tuna Day. Tuna is a famous fish eaten all over the world. 3rd May was World Press Freedom Day. And the theme was Keeping Power in Check, Media, Justice and the Rule of Law. Please note, World Press Freedom Day is very important, and also there was a Press Freedom Index also that was released by Reporters Without Borders. This is an organization based in Paris, and India's rank is 138. Now 4th May is International Firefighter Day, and remember that Tania Sanyal, don't forget this name, Tania Sanyal is the first woman who has been incorporated by Airport Authority of India as a firefighter. First ever woman appointed as a firefighter by Airport Authority of India, and Airport Authority of India is headed by Guru Prasad Mohapatra. Guru Prasad Mohapatra is the chairman of Airport Authority of India. World Cartoonist Day was 5th of May. International No Diet Day, 6th of May. World Athletics Day, 7th of May. World Red Cross and Red Crescent Day with the theme Memorable Smiles from Around the World was on 8th of May. National Technology Day, 11th of May. This was the day when we carried out Operation Shakti, which was the nuclear test in Pokhran, Rajasthan. International Nurses Day, theme was Nurses, a Voice to Lead, Health is a Human Right, and this is celebrated as birthday of Florence Nightingale. Florence Nightingale birthday is celebrated as International Nurses Day, which is on 12th of May. Some more, 12th May was also the World Migratory Bird Day, and the theme was Unifying Our Voices for Bird Conservation. 15th May was International Day of Families, theme was Families and Inclusive Society. 16th May was World Agritourism Day with the theme Development and Doubling the Farmer's Income Through Agritourism. Also remember that India's target to double farmer income is 2022. 16th May was International Day of Light and International Day of Living Together in Peace. 17th May, there were 3 days, the World Telecommunication and Information Society Day with the theme Enabling the Positive Use of Artificial Intelligence for All. 17th May is also the International Day Against Homophobia, Transphobia and Biphobia. Alliances for Solidarity was the theme. 17th May was also the World Hypertension Day. Hypertension means increased blood pressure. Know your numbers, because 120 by 80 is the normal blood pressure. 120 is systole, 80 is diastole. 18th May was the World AIDS Vaccine Day. AIDS is caused by human immunodeficiency virus, and India's target to eliminate AIDS is 2030. 18th May was the International Museum Day with the theme Hyperconnected Museum, New Approaches, New Publics. 20th May was also the World Bee Day. When we rear bees, it is called apiculture. Bees are usually reared for pollination and for honey and all those things. 21st May was the World Day for Cultural Diversity for Dialogue and Development, and Anti-Terrorism Day. Anti-Terrorism Day is the day when our former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi was killed in 1991 by LTTE. 22nd May is the International Day for Biological Diversity, and it was celebrating 25 years of action for biodiversity was the theme, because in 1992 we had the Rio Earth Summit happened at Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. 23rd May was the International Day to End Obstetric Fistula, and the theme was Leaving No One Behind, Let Us Commit to Ending Fistula Now. 24th May was the Commonwealth Day. New Commonwealth head is Prince Charles, earlier it was Queen Elizabeth, and the theme is Towards a Common Future. 29th May is International Day of UN Peacekeeper, and the theme is UN Peacekeeper 70 years of service and sacrifice. Remember that India is the largest contributor to UN Peacekeeper with 2 lakh soldiers. World No Tobacco Day, celebrated by WHO, and the theme was Tobacco and Heart Disease. It was on 31st of May. What is India's rank on the World Press Freedom Index released by Reporters Without Borders? India's rank was a very, very poor 138, and Reporters Without Borders is headquartered in Paris. Paris also has the headquarter of UNESCO and of OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, and also Reporters Without Borders. Paris will also host the 2024 Olympic Games. It is the capital of France. French president is Emmanuel Macron. Now, in this index, you should also know which is the first country, the best country for press people, the media, is Norway. And the worst country, which is ranked the last, it is North Korea. It is ranked 180th. Central government has given its approval for signing of a memorandum of understanding in the field of medicinal plant, traditional system of medicine and homeopathy with which country? This they have done with Sao Tome and Principe. Sao Tome and Principe. Ayush, our minister for Ayush is Shripad Yesso Nayak. He is our Ayush minister. And also remember, Ayush now is a word. It has been accepted as a word. It is no more an acronym. Even if you say Ayush, it is understood you are talking about the traditional Indian system of medicine, Ayurveda, Yoga, Unani, Siddha, Homeopathy. And these are the MOUs which we signed recently, that is in the month of May. With Peru, we signed for new and renewable energy. With Myanmar, we signed a lot of MOUs, and Myanmar's president is Win Myint, and foreign minister is Aung San Suu Kyi. Suriname, we signed in the field of electoral management and administration, and India's electoral the election commissioner, chief election commissioner is O.P. Rawat. Swaziland, we signed in health and medicine, and Swaziland's new name is Eswatini. French, we signed for railways and renewable energy. With Morocco, we signed for mining and geology and for legal. Colombia, traditional system of medicine. Equatorial Guinea, traditional system of medicine and medicinal plant. Angola, which is a member of OPEC also. Electronics and Information Technology. Turkey, for trade in poppy seeds. We will import poppy seeds from Turkey. Denmark, we signed for food safety. Singapore, personnel management and public administration. And with Japan and South Korea, we signed for export of iron ore through MMTC. South Africa, for the ICAI, that is the Chartered Accountant Institute of India. And we signed with their Chartered Accountant Institute, so that now the degree is the CAs of India, Chartered Accountants, can now practice in South Africa also. The degree is recognized there also. Kuwait, we signed double taxation avoidance agreement. Brunei, we signed for exchange of information regarding the taxes. Panama, we signed for agriculture and visa exemption. This is very, very important, all the MOUs. Who has launched his political party called Hamro Sikkim? Sikkim state animal is Red Panda. Sikkim's capital is Gangtok. Sikkim CM, who is the longest serving CM in the Indian history, is Pawan Chamling, and his name is Baichung Bhutia. His political party is Hamro Sikkim. And Sikkim is the first organic state of India. It is also the first open defecation free state of India. Which state's cabinet has approved the proposal to start a free air ambulance service? This decision has been taken by the government of Himachal Pradesh. They will use helicopter as ambulance. Who launched the Van Dhan scheme of the Ministry of Tribal Affairs and Trifed? The Minister for Tribal Affairs is Jual Oram. Jual Oram. And it was launched by Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi. Also remember that the first Van Dhan Vikas Kendra. First Van Dhan Vikas Kendra was opened in Bijapur. And Bijapur is in Chhattisgarh. Also, under Ayushman Bharat scheme, the first hospital or the first health and wellness center was also opened in Bijapur in Chhattisgarh. And there is a scheme called Gobar Dhan, in which basically we want to create bio-CNG and biogas using the cow dung. Gobar Dhan scheme was launched from Karnal, which is in Haryana. Which is in Haryana. And there is something known as Rashtriya Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. Rashtriya Gram Swaraj Abhiyan scheme was launched from Mandla. Mandla is in Madhya Pradesh. So, I told you four questions in one. Who has been appointed by the government of Haryana as the brand ambassador for Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakram and Measles and Rubella vaccination campaign? There were two people who were selected. Earlier it was Manu Bhakar and later it was Gauri Sharon. They both are Commonwealth Gold Medalist and they both are in shooting. So there are two brand ambassadors, Manu Bhakar and Gauri Sharon. Manu Bhakar is only 16 years old, but the youngest medal winner from Commonwealth was Anish Bhanwala. He is only 15 years old. He is also from Haryana. Manu Bhakar is also from Haryana. Gauri Sharon also from Haryana. Haryana was the number one medal winner, followed by Maharashtra, which was number two. Union Cabinet has given its approval for declaration of scheduled areas under the fifth schedule in which state? So there are three districts in Rajasthan, like Dungarpur, Banaswar, etc., where 227 villages have been declared as scheduled areas, giving more protection to the tribal people. Because tribal people, they don't feel secure anymore. Because we have seen, for example, in Odisha, how tribals were thrown out of the Simlipal Tiger Reserve. These tribals were called the Mankedia tribe. Mankedia tribe in Odisha were thrown out of Simlipal Tiger Reserve very, very recently. And also even in Assam, there is something known as a Amchang Wildlife Sanctuary. And from Amchang Wildlife Sanctuary, lot of tribals were thrown out recently. So it's good to give protection to the tribal areas. And Tribal Affair Minister is Jual Oram. Jual Oram, by the way, is a Lok Sabha MP from Sundargarh in Odisha. So the state is Rajasthan. Scientists have identified a new species of frog which is called Fajarvarya Gomachi. Now Fajarvarya Gomachi is a frog discovered where? Now it was called Gomachi because it was discovered in Goa. CM is Manohar Parikar. And there was also a snake that was discovered called Europeltis Bhupatei. It is called Europeltis Bhupatei after Mr. S. Bhupati, who was a great scientist of insects. So this was from Anaikatti Hills in Tamil Nadu. And there is another frog called Microhylacodial. It was discovered from Mangaluru in Karnataka. Now remember, Mangaluru airport was declared as the cleanest airport of India recently. And Anaikatti Hills in Tamil Nadu, there is one more hills that you need to remember, which are called Bodhi West Hills. And again, Bodhi West Hills is also in Tamil Nadu. Why Bodhi West Hills is important? Because here India has made India Neutrino Observatory Project. This is very close to the Kerala border and only 5 kilometers away from the Mathiketan Shola National Park of Kerala. So that is why getting environment clearance for the India Neutrino Observatory Project, which is in Bodhi West Hills in Tamil Nadu, was very, very difficult. Who has been sworn in as the 70th Secretary of State of America? In America, the Foreign Minister is called Secretary of State. India's Foreign Minister is Sushma Swaraj. The person in question is Mike Pompeo. Mike Pompeo earlier was the director of the CIA, Central Investigative Agency of America. Just like we have CBI, America has CIA. And since Mike Pompeo has now relinquished his position as CIA director and he has become the foreign minister, so new CIA director of America is Gina Haspel. And let me tell you, Gina Haspel is the first ever woman from America to be becoming the CIA director. And these are some of the most important positions that you need to remember from America and from China. One question is must. Now, you only need to remember National Security Advisor, Secretary of State, Defense Secretary, Chief Economic Advisor and CIA Director. You don't need to remember all of these four. Okay. So, National Security Advisor is John Bolton of Donald Trump. Secretary of State is Mike Pompeo. Defense Secretary James Mattis. And Secretary of Treasury is Steve You don't need to remember Secretary of Treasury actually. You need to remember Chief Economic Advisor Larry Kudlow. India's Chief Economic Advisor is who? Arvind Subramaniam. CIA director is Gina Haspel. Who is India's national security advisor? Ajit Doval. And Donald Trump is the president of America. He's from Republican Party. His wife name is Melania Trump and his daughter name is Ivanka Trump. Melania Trump is also called the first lady. Now let's talk about China. China's president is Xi Jinping. The state councillor is Wang Yi. Prime minister is Li Keqiang. Vice president is Wang Qishan. Super important. Who is the vice president of China? Very important question. And the central bank of China, which is called the People's Bank of China, just like we have Reserve Bank of India headed by Urjit Patel, China has People's Bank of China headed by Yi Gang. Which union ministry has launched the second edition of the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan? Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, in which 750 students from the higher educational institutions of India, they will go to villages, they will adopt these villages and they will try to do the development of those villages. And IIT Delhi is the, what you call, the coordinating institute for all the students, 750 students. This is launched by the Ministry of Human Resource Development headed by Prakash Javadekar. Which of the following has announced to launch the Atal New India Challenge? Atal New India Challenge is launched by Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog Vice Chairman is Rajiv Kumar, CEO is Amitabh Kant, Chairman is Pradhan Mantri Modi. Niti Aayog has also started 115 aspirational district scheme. Out of 115 aspirational district, maximum have been given to Jharkhand 19, followed by Bihar 13, followed by Chhattisgarh 10. Which company has signed a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of Tourism? It has adopted Red Fort and Gandikonda Fort in Andhra Pradesh under Adopt a Heritage Project. This company is Dalmia Bharat. Dalmia Bharat. These are the 22 monuments which are a part of the phase 4 of this scheme. So you don't need to remember which monument has been adopted by which company, but you need to know which monument is located where. This is a part of your static JK. For example, if they ask where is Bara Lao ka Gumbad, it is in Delhi. So Lotus Mahal, Elephant Stable in Hampi. Hampi is a World Heritage Site, by the way. Krishna Temple, an ancient pathway revival from Virupaksha Temple. Virupaksha is a very important temple in Karnataka. You have Kamakhya Temple in Guwahati, very famous again. All these important temples, like there is a, what you call, Padmanabha Swami Temple, which is in Thiruvananthapuram in Kerala. You have Shabrimala Temple in Kerala. Brihadeshwara Temple in Tanjavur in Tamil Nadu. So do check out your static JK, it's important. Which union minister, he conferred the National Safety Awards, which are called Sarvashrestha Suraksha Puraskar 2017 at a function that was held in New Delhi. These awards were given by the Minister of State for Labour, who is our Labour Minister, Santosh Kumar Gangwar. India is going to tie up with which countries to develop a pollution forecast system? Pollution forecast system India is developing with Finland and US. So the answer is 1 and 2. Finland's capital is Helsinki. Also remember, right now India is using SAFAR system. Suffer. Who launched a mobile app called Mobile Awas for allotment of government accommodation in general pool residential accommodation? He is the Minister for Housing and Urban Affairs. He is Hardeep Singh Puri. Who has won this year's Martha Farrell Award for Excellence in Women Empowerment? What is her name? She is Nadia Safi. She is a human rights activist from Srinagar in Jammu and Kashmir. Tony Daniel passed away. He was associated with what? He was associated with sports. And he was an Indian sprinter. These are some people who passed away in the month of May. They went to heavenly abode. They left us. Balantrapu Rajinikant Rao. He was a writer and composer. P.P. Lakshman was president of All India Football Federation. Right now it is Praful Patel. Ashok Mitra was an economist. He was a former chief economic advisor of India. Brigadier Francis Regis Campos. He was a veteran of the India-Pak 1971 Bangladesh Liberation War. Kottayam Pushpanath was a novelist. Ravindar Sharma, artist. K.R. Bhushan, freedom fighter. He was also a member of parliament from Raipur constituency. Dev Michener was animator, cartoonist. Idris Hasan Latif was the chief of IAF, Indian Air Force. Dr. Nirmal Hirawat was a politician. He was a congress minister from Madhya Pradesh government. Arun Date was a Marathi singer. B.N. Vijay Kumar was a politician. He was a BJP MLA from Karnataka. Anna Coates was an editor. Rajender Pal was a cricketer. Ankit Chadha was a storyteller. He had a style called Dastang, a style of storytelling. David Goodall was a botanist and ecologist from Australia. Balkavi Bairagi was a poet and politician. Real name was Nandaram Das Bairagi. Yamuna Bai Vaikar was a Lawani singer from Maharashtra. Tom Wolfe was a journalist. Zhao Kangmin was an archaeologist. He had discovered China's terracotta warriors. Very, very important. Balakumaran was a writer from Tamil Nadu. Raghubir Singh was a freedom fighter. Vinod Bhatt was a writer. He was a Gujarati writer. Bansidhar Panda was industrialist and he was the founder of Indian Metal and Ferroalloys. He was from Odisha. And Yadanapudi Sulochana Rani was a writer. Bureau of Indian Standards, it has granted the first license for liquid chlorine on all India basis. Now, which company has been given the license to manufacture liquid chlorine, which is used in paper industry and various other industries? It is Gujarat Alkali and Chemicals Limited. In Gujarat, you will find something known as Vela Vadar National Park, which is famous for black buck. You will also find Marine National Park, Run of Kutch, and you will find Gir National Park, which houses lions, Asiatic lion. Which Indian weightlifter won 2 medals at the Asian Youth and Junior Weightlifting Championship that took place in Urganj in Uzbekistan? Uzbekistan's capital is Tashkent. His name is Jeremy Lal Rinunga. These were some of the important awards won by, important tournaments won by various people in the month of May. Let's talk about Formula 1. So, Azerbaijan Grand Prix and Spanish Grand Prix both were won by Lewis Hamilton. He drives the car Mercedes and he's from UK, Britain. Barcelona Football Club won the Spanish League called La Liga. India won the Four Nation Under 16 tournament in football. Atletico Madrid won the UEFA Europa League. And don't confuse UEFA Europa League with UEFA Champions League. Champions League was won by Real Madrid, not Atletico Madrid. Kochi Football Tournament, it was the National Blind Football Tournament. It was held in Kochi and it was won by Kochi. South Korea won the gold medal and India won the silver medal in the 5th Women's Asia Champions Trophy in hockey. Bala Prasanth, he won the Formula Junior Racing Series 2018 Championship in racing. CA Bhavani Devi won the silver medal in the Tournoi World Cup Women's Satellite Fencing Tournament in Sabre Fencing. Shooting, let's talk about shooting. Gagan Narang and Pooja Ghatkar, they won the silver medal in the Grand Prix of Liberation International Shooting Competition in 10-meter air rifle. In shooting, Tejaswini Sawant and Anjum Modgil, they won the gold and silver respectively in the Munich Grand Prix in the women's 50-meter rifle prone. In the shooting, Chen Singh won silver medal in the Munich Grand Prix men's 50-meter rifle prone. And Hina Sidhu, who is also a doctor and a shooter, she won the gold medal in the international shooting competition of Hanover in the women's 10-meter air pistol. Let's talk about squash. Ramit Tandon, he won the Abu Dhabi Open in men's single. And in tennis, you should remember Prajesh Guneswaran. He won the Kunming Open ATP Challenger Circuit. And he's of course an Indian. Rafael Nadal won 2 tournaments, Barcelona Open and Italian Open. Alexander Zverev won the Madrid Open. And Petra Kvitova won the Madrid Open in female. Which of the following Indian entrepreneurs has been named in the 2018 Time Magazine's 100 Most Powerful People or Influential People in the World? There were many people. Like there was Deepika Padukone, actress, Virat Kohli, cricketer, Satya Nadella, CEO of Microsoft, and we had Bhavish Agarwal, who is the CEO of Ola. These are the 4 Indians who made it to the 100 most influential people in the world. Which state government has launched Mission Lakadong? This is to boost the production of Lakadong turmeric. It is Meghalaya. Meghalaya is a northeastern state. Now remember, Meghalaya, recently Armed Forces Special Power Act was removed from Meghalaya completely. These are the latest governors of northeastern state. A lot of people get confused, but this is very, very latest. So BD Mishra is Arunachal Pradesh, Ganga Prasad, Meghalaya, Jagdish Mukhi, Manipur, and Jagdish Mukhi also for Assam. Kumanam Rajashekaran, he is the new governor of Mizoram, and Mizoram has a Congress government. Mizoram, Punjab, and Karnataka in coalition with Janata Dal Secular. These are the only 3 places where we have Congress government right now in India. Nagaland is PB Acharya, Tathagat Roy, Tripura, Srinivas Patil, Sikkim, and Ganeshi Lal is the new governor of Odisha. 127th Khong Jom Day, it was recently celebrated on 23rd April in which state? It was celebrated in Manipur. Why in Manipur? Because this is to pay tribute to the Anglo-Manipur War, which happened in 1891. Manipur also has important players like Mary Kom, like for example Mirabai Chanu. Mirabai Chanu won the first gold medal for India at the Commonwealth in Queensland, Gold Coast, Australia. And CM is Biren Singh of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Which exercise did Indian Navy conduct recently in Kerala, Mahe, Lakshadweep and Minicoy Island? It was called Sagar Kavach. Sagar Kavach. Also remember, Indian Army recently got the bulletproof jacket, which was called Bhabha Kavach. Bhabha Kavach was named after Dr. Homi Bhabha, who was father of the Indian nuclear program. And Bhabha Kavach is manufactured by BARC, also called Bhabha Atomic Research Center. Which institute has developed lighter bulletproof jacket called Bhabha Kavach? It is BARC, Bhabha Atomic Research Center. Shirui Lili Festival was held in which state? Shirui Lili is the state bird of Manipur. So it took place in Manipur. And Manipur state animal is Sangai. Mario Abdo Benitez, he has been elected as the president of which country? He has been elected as the president of a country whose capital is Asuncion. And it is Paraguay. Paraguay, Asuncion. These are the latest in president or prime minister of new president and new prime minister of various country. So Mario Abdo Benitez for Paraguay, he is the new president. Carlos Alvarado is the new president of Costa Rica. Nicolas Maduro has been re-elected as the new president of Venezuela. Nicole Pashinyan, he is the new prime minister of Armenia. Dmitry Medvedev, he is the new prime minister of Russia. And Mahathir Mohamad, he replaced Najib Razak as the new prime minister of Malaysia. He is 92 years old and he is the oldest prime minister in the world right now. These are the new Indian ambassadors. So Krishan Kumar is the new ambassador of India to Norway, Rajiv Kumar Nagpal to Venezuela, Narendra Chauhan to Czech Republic, Munnu Mahawar to Oman, SD Murthy South Sudan, Mahinder Singh Kanyal Suriname, and Pradeep Kumar Gupta Mauritania. Which state government has launched a Pravasi pension scheme? Pravasi pension scheme, it is for those like who are from Kerala but they are living outside Kerala or outside India or outside Kerala. They will get a pension of 2000 per month. So this has been launched by the government of Kerala. Kerala is headed by, the CM is Pinarayi Vijayan. Party is CPIM. Which company has partnered with the Ministry of Tourism to bring a series of 360 degree virtual reality videos for the Incredible India Tourism campaign? 360 degree virtual reality videos will be created by Google Arts and Culture. Google also had a recent software called Google Home. It's a machine basically. It is based on artificial intelligence. India is conducting a joint military exercise called Harimo Shakti. This is the first ever exercise of India with which country? We conducted it with Malaysia. The Home Ministry has removed AFSPA, Armed Forces Special Power Act, from which state? It has removed it from Meghalaya. And it has also removed it from some places in Arunachal Pradesh, but not all. And it is still there in Nagaland, Assam, Manipur, etc. How much amount of loan has the World Bank signed to fund Innovate in India for Inclusiveness project? World Bank is giving a loan to India of $125 million. World Bank's president is Jim Yong Kim. This project will be ending in 2023 and World Bank is headquartered in Washington, D.C. These are four more loans that you need to remember. India has got a loan of 125, as I said, for Innovate in India for Inclusiveness project. It has got a loan of 1600 crore for National Biopharma Mission. $200 million for Poshan Abhiyan, which was launched from Jhunjhunu in Rajasthan. Poshan Abhiyan was launched from Jhunjhunu. It is also called National Nutrition Mission. And India Energy Efficiency Scale-Up Program, India got a loan of $300 million and $200 million for Poshan Abhiyan. Pradhan Mantri Modi recently released a commemorative postage stamp on Hemavati Nandan Bahuguna. Now, he was the former chief minister of which state? He was the former chief minister of United Uttar Pradesh. And of course, Uttarakhand got separated from Uttar Pradesh. And Uttarakhand CM right now is Trivendra Singh Rawat, who launched a afforestation drive, that is tree plantation drive on Rispana River recently. In Uttar Pradesh, you will find Katarniya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary. Katarniya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary, you will find Pilibhit Tiger Reserve, which is on the Nepal border. And you will also find Dudhwa National Park, which is in Lakhimpur Kheri. Which team won the third edition of the National Blind Football Tournament held in Kochi? It was won by Kochi and Kochi beat Bengaluru in the final. This is a football tournament. Which airline has recently joined the International Air Transport Association, which is called IATA? It is Vistara. And Vistara is a joint venture between Tata Group and Singapore Airlines. Which state government has initiated a new project called Bhuseva? Bhuseva has been started by Andhra Pradesh. It has Papikonda National Park. It has Nagarjun Sagar Dam also, and there is a Nagarjun Sagar National Park also. And the area of Nagarjun Sagar National Park, which is there in Telangana, is called Amrabad Tiger Reserve. It is called Nagarjun Sagar Sri Salam Tiger Reserve, by the way, in Andhra. And CM is Chandrababu Naidu. Which institute has set up India's first virtual bronchoscopy navigation? This will help to diagnose lung cancer, etc. So it is AIIMS. AIIMS, All India Institute of Medical Science. Recently, a new AIIMS is being set up in Deogad. Deogad is in Jharkhand. And also remember, AIIMS director is Randeep Guleria. He is the director of AIIMS. By the way, AIIMS also won the Kaya Kalp Award recently. Which bank has launched their robot called Era? So Eva and Era, they both are the robots of HDFC Bank. It is the only bank in India with a market valuation of more than $100 billion, headed by Aditya Puri. Which chief minister has surpassed Jyoti Basu's record? He has now become the longest serving chief minister of any state in India. He is Sikkim Chief Minister Pawan Chamling. Which government has announced to set up Rogi Kalyan Samiti in each assembly constituency? Rogi Kalyan Samiti will be set up by the government of Delhi. Delhi government also became the first government in India to have a policy where if there is a unplanned power cut, then the people of Delhi will get compensation. As per Niti Aayog Vice Chairman Rajiv Kumar, what will be India's GDP growth in the financial year 2019, that is from 1st April 2018 to 31st March 2019, India's GDP growth will be a healthy 7.5%. Who has been conferred 26th PC Chandar Puraskar? It has been given to Asha Bhosle, sister of Lata Mangeshkar. Who took over as the 27th Director General of the Press Information Bureau? It is Sitanshu Kar, and he has replaced Frank Noronha. Also remember, India's new Information Broadcasting Minister is Rajyavardhan Singh Rathaur, and Smriti Irani was removed. She is now only Textile Minister. And these are some of the new position, appointments, or you can say, new responsibilities bestowed upon various people. Kavinder Gupta is Deputy Chief Minister, new Deputy Chief Minister of Jammu Kashmir, and Chief Minister is Mehbooba Mufti Sayyed. Rahul Bhatia is the new CEO of Indigo. Justin Langer is the new head coach of Australian cricket team. He replaced Daniel Lehman. Tim Payne is the new captain of Australian one-day cricket team, and Aaron Finch of the Australian T20 cricket team. Mallikarjun Khadge is chairman of Public Accounts Committee. Murli Manohar Joshi is the chairman for Parliamentary Committee on Estimates. Mukul Rohatgi has been appointed as an eminent jurist to the Lokpal Selection Committee. Mukul Rohatgi is of course the ex-Attorney General of India. Right now, Attorney General of India is K.K. Venugopal. Rajinder Singh is the new president of Hockey India. He replaced Mariamma Koshi. Dilip Turki is the chairman of Odisha Tourism Development Corporation. He was a hockey player. C.K. Prasad is the chairman of Press Council of India. Uttam Pacharne is the chairman of Lalit Kala Academy. Anubrata Biswas, MD and CEO of Airtel Payment Bank. Which of the following states celebrated Statehood Day on May the 1st? It was celebrated by two states, Gujarat and Maharashtra. So the answer is 1 and 2. Gujarat governor is Om Prakash Kohli. And Om Prakash Kohli is also, he has been given additional charge of Madhya Pradesh recently. After Anandiben Patel, she went on leave. Which Indian sabre fencer won silver medal at the Tornoi World Cup Women's Satellite Fencing Tournament that was held in the capital of Iceland, Reykjavik? She is C.A. Bhavani Devi. ABB has commissioned India's first industrial solar microgrid in which city? This city is Vadodara. And remember, India's largest solar park is in Pavagada village in Tumkur in Karnataka. It is called Shakti Sthal. And now, India's largest solar park will be built in Dholera in the Gulf of Khambat area in Gujarat. Who is going to chair the second World Hindu Congress to be held in Chicago? And if you remember, Chicago is the same place where Swami Vivekananda gave his historic speech on 11th of September 1893. She is Tulsi Gabbard. Which union minister launched the Gobardhan scheme along with Haryana CM Manohar Lal Khattar from the National Dairy Research Institute in Karnal in Haryana? It was launched by Uma Bharti. You can see Uma Bharti and his Manohar Khattar. National Disaster Management Authority, they conducted their first ever mock exercise on bio disaster at which airport? It was conducted at the Lok Nayak Jai Prakash Narayan Airport, which is basically the airport in Bihar, in Patna. Rashtrapati Ramnath Kovind, he is the 14th President of India. He attended the 620th Pragotsav of Satguru Kabir in which state? This took place in Sagar. Sagar is a district in Madhya Pradesh, and Sagar will also be built as a smart city. Total, there will be seven smart cities in Madhya Pradesh and 99 in India. Which Formula One driver won the Azerbaijan Grand Prix? It was won by Lewis Hamilton. And there have been six races so far in the 2018 season. Australian Grand Prix, Sebastian Vettel, he drives Ferrari. Bahrain Grand Prix, Sebastian Vettel, Ferrari. Chinese Grand Prix, Daniel Ricciardo, Red Bull. Azerbaijan and Spanish Grand Prix by Lewis Hamilton, he drives Mercedes. And Monaco Grand Prix by again Daniel Ricciardo, he is from Team Red Bull. Who has been selected for 2017 Saraswati Samman for his collection of poems called Vakhar? Vakhar, whom am I talking about? I am talking about Sitanshu Yashaschandra. And where is he from? He is from Gujarat, Gandhinagar. Which railway station is going to be the third railway station in India to get airport-like facilities by 2020? First railway station was Habibganj in Bhopal. Then there was Gujarat Gandhinagar railway station, and now third one would be Surat. Surat is also called Diamond City, and it is in basically Gujarat. India is going to have a national database on disaster ready by which year? It will be ready by 2020. How many medals did India win at the 56th Belgrade International Boxing Tournament that took place in Serbia? India won total of 13 medals. 3 gold medal, 5 silver medal and 5 bronze medal. Who have been selected as India's representatives at the Football for Friendship social program, which will be held in Moscow, Russia? And in Moscow, Russia, we will also have the Football FIFA World Cup. So it will be Surya Varikutty and Rudresh Godanur. Surya Varikutty and Rudresh Godanur. Which of the following has declared all protected areas and forest reserves in India as plastic free zone? It is the Ministry of Environment, headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. Also remember, there is a Mankadia tribe in Odisha. It has been thrown out of the Simlipal Tiger Reserve in Odisha. What is India's rank in the list of doping violation published by World Anti-Doping Agency? Number one is Italy in this list. And then we have India at the sixth place. India is ranked sixth. India has actually improved its position. India was third for the last 3 years in a row. Now first is Italy, second is France, and third is America. Now also remember, World Anti-Doping Agency is headquartered in Montreal, which is in Canada. Who has been appointed as the coach of the national men's team by Hockey India? National men's coach is now Harinder Singh. And women's hockey team coach is Joard Marijne. Joard Marijne. So they have actually kind of swapped it, because female hockey team coach was Harinder Singh and men's was Joard Marijne. Now it is opposite. Now men's hockey team will be coached by Harinder Singh and female will be Joard Marijne. Which state chief minister inaugurated a 39.65 crore Kanda Pattan Saraghat water supply scheme at Choltara? Where is it? It is in Mandi district. Mandi is a district in Himachal Pradesh. Jairam Thakur is the CM. The government of Maharashtra has announced to rename which university after Bahina Bai Chaudhary? This is the North Maharashtra University. Maharashtra also declared a new wildlife sanctuary at a place called Ghodazari in Chandrapur district. Which Nobel Prize for 2018 has been postponed by the Swedish Academy? It is for literature, and next year they will give 2 instead of 1. Pakyong Airport became the 100th airport in India. Where is it? It is in Sikkim. Also remember, in Arunachal recently the first commercial flight landed at Pasighat. Which state's chief minister launched Go to Village or Khun Gang Chatsi mission in the state? He is Biren Singh and he is the CM of Manipur. Capitalism fall. Which state has become the first to provide digitally signed land record receipt? These will be accepted now by Maharashtra, and these will be called 7x12 receipts. Indian Army's Southwestern Command is conducting the exercise called Vijay Prahar in which state? This is being conducted in Suratgarh. Suratgarh is in Rajasthan. Which of the following items has recently been banned by the Ministry of Environment? It is party poopers, because they can potentially explode. You know, they can act as explosives. Employees Provident Fund Organization, it has allowed the pensioners to view their pension passbook via which app? This app is manufactured by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology called MeitY, M-E-I-T-Y. It is called the Umang app. Which spacecraft has been launched by NASA to study Mars quake from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California? This mission is called InSight. InSight is for Mars, Mission Juno is for Jupiter, and Cassini is for Saturn. Central government has given its approval for acceding to the protocol under the WHO Framework Convention on what? This is on tobacco control, and India is now a part of this convention on tobacco control. So India will have to abide by all the rules and regulation to control tobacco, both the chewable and the smokable tobacco. Also remember, WHO Director General is Tedros Adhanom from Ethiopia, and Deputy Director General is Soumya Swaminathan of India. And WHO is headquartered in Geneva. And 31st May is the World No Tobacco Day. Who chaired the first meeting? You know that on 2nd of October 2019, it will be the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, father of the nation. And there will be a grand celebration. For that, there is a committee, right, which has 124 people. Now, tell me, who is the head of this committee? Who headed the first meeting of this committee? It was President Ram Nath Kovind. He is the 14th President of India. Who is the new chairman of Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, IRDAI? He has replaced T.S. Vijayan. His name is Subhash Chandra Khuntia. Now, Tapanuli orangutan are in danger because of one belt, one road. There is a dam being built called Botang Toru Dam. In which country? This is Indonesia, and we are talking about Sumatra Island. A Dakota DC-3 VP-905. This aircraft has been gifted to Indian Air Force by Rajiv Chandrasekhar. He is a Rajya Sabha MP. This aircraft has been renamed as what by the Indian Air Force? It will be called Parshuram. In the last question, also remember, Indonesia has allowed India to dock its military at Sabang port. As per SIPRI, which is headquartered in Stockholm, capital of Sweden, Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, India has surpassed which country to become the world's fifth biggest military spender? The highest military spender is America, followed by China. And then we have Saudi Arabia, Russia, and now India. So India has leapfrogged France. France used to be fifth, but now India is fifth. Who has been appointed as interim judge to the civil court of the New York City? She is an Indian. Her name is Deepa Ambekar. Which railway station has been adjudged as the most beautiful station on Indian Railway? And the dirtiest railway station is Kanpur. And Kanpur railway station is also, Kanpur city is also the city with the worst air quality in India with respect to PM2.5 as declared by WHO. Which railway station is the most beautiful? It is Chandarpur and Balarsa station. It is in Nagpur. Which state government, along with World Wildlife Fund India, is conducting the first organized census of Indus dolphin? Indus dolphin are found only in Punjab, in Bias River. And also remember, there is one more dolphin, which is called Irrawaddy dolphin, named after the Irrawaddy River in Myanmar. And Irrawaddy dolphin maximum in India are found in Odisha in Chilka Lake. How many Indian cities have been featured in WHO list of 20 most polluted cities in the world in terms of PM2.5 level? It is 14. And the worst air quality is in Kanpur. Central government has approved earlier under the Pradhan Mantri Vaya Vandana Yojana, you could invest only 7.5 lakh. Now it has been doubled to 15 lakh. 15 lakh. This is the new limit under Pradhan Mantri Vaya Vandana Yojana. Also, you will get a fixed interest of 8%. This scheme is only for senior citizen, and LIC is the implementing organization for the same. Who has become the first African player to be named Footballer of the Year by Footballer Writer Association? He is the player of the year in English football, English Premier League. He is Mohamed Salah from Liverpool. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, they have renamed Multi-Sectoral Development Program as what? Now it will be called Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Now, important thing to understand here is that this is only for those villages where minority population is significant. Earlier, it was 50%, the limit, not the limit, the cutoff. Means those villages who have a minority population of more than 50%, they were eligible for Pradhan Mantri Jan Vikas Karyakram. Now it has been reduced to only 25%. What is India Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi's rank on the most powerful people in the world? The most powerful people in the world, number one is Xi Jinping, president of China. Number two is Vladimir Putin, president of Russia. Pradhan Mantri Modi is at 9th place. President Ramnath Kovind has approved which state or union territory government's bill to amend the Minimum Wages Act, under which employees violating labor rule will face a fine of 20,000 to 50,000 rupees. So you have to pay equal work for equal pay. If you don't, you will get a fine. This has been done by recently in Delhi. Who inaugurated the cochlear implant awareness program called Swar Swagatam in Faridabad? Faridabad, we also have the Surajkund Mela, Surajkund Fair, which is the largest handicraft mela in India. And this time, it always takes place from 1st to 14th of February. And this time, the theme state was Uttar Pradesh. Therefore, it was inaugurated by Yogi Adityanath, the CM of Uttar Pradesh. So, who inaugurated the cochlear implant awareness program? It was, Krishan Pal Gurjar. Who is he? He is the Minister of State for Social Justice and Empowerment. Which state government will provide a subsidy of 3 rupees on every liter of milk if you use the milk to manufacture milk powder? This decision has been taken by the government of Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, we have two nuclear power plants. One is called Jaitapur and one is called Tarapur. Which state government has launched India's first integrated control and command center for all the 7 smart cities of the state? 7 smart cities will be built in Madhya Pradesh, like Indore, Bhopal, Ujjain, Gwalior, Jabalpur, Satna and Sagar. These are the 7 smart cities. What is the name of the mineral recently found by the scientist? It can reveal about the water ice under the surface of the moon. This mineral is called moganite, and this was discovered by Japan scientist. Which country has agreed with India to support each other's candidature for the non-permanent membership of the United Nations Security Council? India will support Guatemala's candidature and Guatemala will support India's candidature. There are only 5 permanent members of the United Nations Security Council, but we are talking about non-permanent membership here. United Nations is headquartered in New York, same place where we have a headquarter of UNICEF, and United Nations was formed on 24th October. Which state chief minister has launched NCBN app to connect directly to the citizen? NCBN stands for Nara Chandra Babu Naidu. So he is the CM of Andhra Pradesh. Who has become the world's oldest prime minister? He is 92 years old. He is the prime minister Mahathir Mohamad of Malaysia. Malaysia truly Asia. United Nations Development Program UNDP, they are setting up a skill development center at a place called Bharosa. Where is it? It is in Hyderabad, capital of Telangana. CM is Chandrasekhar Rao. And Skill Development Minister of India is Dharmendra Pradhan. He is also the Oil and Gas Minister. President Ramnath Kovind visited Siachen recently. He became only the second president to visit Siachen. Who was the first? First was APJ Abdul Kalam. And Siachen is also called the third pole. Scientists have discovered world's second oldest rocks in which state in India? It has been recently discovered in Keonjhar district in Odisha. Keonjhar. Which company has awarded National Technology Award? Which company has been awarded for discovering rotavirus vaccine? Rotavirus causes diarrhea in children and it is one of the leading causes of death in India. This company is Bharat Biotech based in Hyderabad. Now, the beaches of Mumbai, they are shining in the night because of the Noctiluca algae. Why it has come? Why it has become active? It is because of global warming. This is in the Northern Arabian Sea, Mumbai coast. Which country's prime minister has announced to host the BIMSTEC summit, which stands for Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation? And there are a lot of countries in BIMSTEC. There are Bangladesh, India, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Thailand, Bhutan and Nepal. So there are 7 countries in BIMSTEC. It will be hosted by Nepal. Kathmandu is the capital. Kathmandu is the headquarters of SAARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. Khadga Prasad Sharma is the prime minister. Bidya Devi Bhandari is the president. And remember, SAARC chairman is Amjad Sial from Pakistan. Which state government has become the first to sign a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy's Green Rating for Integrated Habitat Assessment Council to train the state's Public Works Department officials to rate the government building based on their green quotient? This state is Maharashtra again. The CM is Devendra Fadnavis. Which state's chief minister has launched Raitu Bandhu scheme, which means Farmers Investment Support Scheme? This has been done by Telangana. Telangana recently declared Urdu as their second official language. Government has approved a new type of license plate for electronic vehicle. The license plate will follow which color code? So the plate will be green color and the font will be either white or yellow. Now white if it is a private car, yellow if it is a taxi or a cab. Supreme Court has approved a scheme for mandatory grant of compensation to poor victim of sexual assault and acid attack. How much minimum compensation will be given to acid attack victim for total disfigurement? It will be 7 lakh rupees. Now let me elucidate. So you will get 5 lakh to 10 lakh if there is a loss of life or gang rape. Minimum 4 lakh if there is a rape or unnatural sexual assault. Minimum 7 lakh for total disfigurement of victim of burning and acid attack. Minimum 5 lakh for 50% burns of victim of burning and acid attack. Indian Navy has sent INS Sumedha for patrolling and surveillance to which country? They have sent it to Maldives. Also remember, there is another Indian ship called Erawat. It has been sent to Bangladesh for providing humanitarian relief to Rohingyas, INS Erawat. And this operation is called Operation Insaniyat. Which state government has signed a pact with the United Kingdom for setting up a bio-CNG and biogas plant? Biogas is nothing but methane. This is Punjab. Punjab has partnered with UK. Niti Aayog has announced to set up how many Atal Tinkering Labs by March 2019? Their target is to set up 5,000 Atal Tinkering Lab in all the districts of India. Indian and French Navy, they conducted Varuna Naval Exercise where? They conducted it in Reunion Island. Who will be the head of the parliamentary panel or committee set up to study the recovery of black money and performance of the public sector bank? He is the senior BJP leader Murali Manohar Joshi. Which company has started a messaging app, group messaging app called Squirrel? It has been started by Yahoo. And also remember Baba Ramdev, he launched his own app as a competitor called Kimbo, competitor to WhatsApp. Which bridge, which is built on river Brahmaputra, has become India's longest rail cum road bridge? It is called Bogibeel Bridge. Bogibil Bridge. It is built by Indian Railways and it is 4.94 km long. It will connect Dibrugarh in Assam to Pasighat in Arunachal Pradesh. Agriculture Minister Radha Mohan Singh has announced to set up a frozen semen station under the Rashtriya Gokul Mission at which place? Rashtriya Gokul Mission is we want to augment, we want to increase our desi variety of animals, the indigenous breeds of animal. So this has been set up in Bihar at a place called Purnia district. Who has been appointed to head the committee set up by the Rajya Sabha chairman and vice president of India Venkaiah Naidu to revise the rules and procedure of the conduct of business in Rajya Sabha? So basically they want to see how the usual day-to-day working of the Rajya Sabha can be upgraded. For that there is a committee and it will be headed by Mr. V.K. Agnihotri. Where was, so in Hyderabad, we unfurled India's largest national flag. Who unfurled it? It is Pawan Kalyan, famous actor and politician. His party is called Jana Party. Jana Sena, okay? Jana Sena Party. And remember that this Indian flag in Hyderabad is the largest. It is 122 feet in length and 183 feet in width. Which state government is conducting generations to generations program with the government of Poland? So this is because way back, and I'm talking about during the World War II, Poland was involved in a war and there were 600 women and children from Poland who were given refuge by the King of Gujarat. That time King of Jamnagar was Digvijay Singh Jadeja. He gave them refuge. So there are cultural relations between Poland and Gujarat. He is Vijay Rupani, CM of Gujarat. Pradhan Mantri Modi and Nepali Prime Minister KP Oli, they flagged off Indo-Nepal bus service under Ramayana circuit at which place? It was flagged off from Janakpur. Also remember, there will be a train between Raxaul in Bihar to Kathmandu in Nepal. Raxaul is a place in Bihar. So here it is written, Raxaul in Bihar, Kathmandu in Nepal. There will be a train link. And also, there will be a 900 megawatt plant in Tumlingar in Nepal. Who has been nominated by the Sikkim government as the Green Ambassador? Green Ambassador is Mohit Chauhan, famous singer. His band is called Silk Route. Which campaign has been launched by the World Health Organization to replace trans fat from food to eliminate them completely by 2023? Trans fat are basically which are the fat produced in industries. And according to WHO, our food should not have more than 1% of trans fat and more than 10% of saturated fat, which is found in butter and meat, etc. The mission is called Replace. Union Cabinet has approved the establishment of National Institute of Mental Health and Rehabilitation at which place? It will be set up in Bhopal, which is the capital of Madhya Pradesh. It is the second cleanest city of India after Indore, which is number one. Which ministry organized a meeting of stakeholders? They are having a skill development program called Samarth. It is the Ministry of Textile. She is our textile minister, Smriti Irani. Remember, there is a skill development program of Ministry of Railways also, which is called Saksham. So don't confuse Saksham with Samarth. Who won the Scientist of the Year award at the DRDO awards presented by Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman? He is S. Pazani Kumar. He was Scientist of the Year for the year 2017. And remember, there is a person called YST Raju. He is Scientist of the Year 2016. Also, V.K. Saraswat, he got the Lifetime Achievement Award by DRDO for 2017. These are the important awards. Lifetime Achievement Award given to V.K. Saraswat for 2017. And Vasudev Kalkunte Atre, V.K. Atre, he got the Lifetime Achievement Award for 2016. So there were four awards which were given. All are very important. Minister for Road Transport and Highway, Nitin Gadkari, he inaugurated two highway, NH7, NH54, from which place? This was launched from Bhatinda. And NH7 will connect Bhatinda to Zirakpur. And NH54 will connect Bhatinda to Amritsar, the Golden Temple City. Indian Army women officers, they recently climbed which mountain? This mountain is Mount Bhagirathi. Second, it is in Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand also has Rajaji Tiger Reserve and Jim Corbett Tiger Reserve. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the development of trunk infrastructure components for the integrated multimodal logistics hub, which is called Freight Village. At which place in Haryana this Freight Village will be established? This place is called Nangal Chaudhary. Also remember, there is a place in Haryana called Sonipat where recently World Design University was set up. Who has authored the book called Hidden India? She is an environment scientist and very renowned wildlife photographer. She is Latika Nath. And these are some books which you need to remember from the month of May. There is a book called My Journey from Marxism-Leninism to Nehruvian Socialism by C.H. Hanumanta Rao. Across the Bench, Insight into the Indian Military Judicial System by Lieutenant General Gyan Bhushan. A Treatise on Cleanliness and Waste Management, an Introduction by Dr. Rajat Bhargav. Mr. M.K. Gandhi Ki Champaran Diary by Arvind Mohan. Champaran was the same place where the first Satyagraha was launched. Champaran Andolan 1917 by Asutosh Partheshwar, editor. And Peer Muhammad Munis Kalam Ka Satyagrahi by Shrikant, editor. What is India's IP, Intellectual Property Rights Policy? And according to that, there is a now a mascot that has been launched by the Minister of Commerce and Industry and also for Civil Aviation Suresh Prabhu. What is it called? It is called IP Nani, Intellectual Property Nani. And also remember that Intellectual Property Nani will have a grandson also called Aditya. Union Cabinet has approved a provision of a new AIIMS. This new AIIMS will be set up where? At a cost of 1103 crore rupees, it will be at Deogad in Jharkhand. Which of the following football association is going to launch their own professional league? It will be launched by Football Delhi. Which company has completed acquisition of more than 72% stake in Bhushan Steel? Bhushan Steel has been acquired by Tata Steel and they have basically converted debt into equity. Which bank has launched Agenda 2525 for budding women entrepreneur? They want to encourage the entrepreneurs in India, especially women entrepreneur. This bank is Yes Bank, headed by Rana Kapoor. The Minister of Environment, Dr. Harshvardhan, he launched Green Skin Development Program. It aims to train 5.5 lakh workers for environment and forest sector through 30 courses by which year? They want to train 5.5 lakh people by 2021. Which railway station in India is the first railway station in India to be powered by solar power only? It is Guwahati Railway Station in Assam. Guwahati also has Kamakhya Temple. Now remember one more thing, that Diu is the first city in India to be powered completely by renewable energy during daytime. Army General Bipin Rawat inaugurated a communication laboratory in which country? This has been set up by Indian Army School of Signals. It has been inaugurated recently in Kandy, and Kandy is a place in Sri Lanka. President is Maithripala Sirisena, Prime Minister is Ranil Wickremesinghe. Who has been elected as the independent chairman of ICC for a second year term? He was the first independent chairman of ICC. His name is Shashank Manohar, and ICC is headquartered in Dubai. Who has been honored with the Lifetime Achievement Award at the Red Ink Awards in Mumbai, given for journalism? He is Mark Tully. He has been given Lifetime Achievement Award. And remember that Journalist of the Year Award was given to Mirror Now's editor Faye D'Souza. India's first all-women run post office passport seva kendra, completely run by women, has been opened where? It has been opened in Fagwada in Punjab. National Thermal Power Corporation NTPC, which is a Maharatan company, it has signed Memorandum of Understanding to acquire 3 power plant. The total capacity is 3470, located in which state? These 3 are one in Muzaffarpur, one in Begusarai, one in Aurangabad, all the 3 are in Bihar. Which country has become the second country in the world to open its new embassy in Jerusalem, the capital of Israel? The second country which has done so is Guatemala, first was America, and now Paraguay is saying they will also shift their embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. Which city is the cleanest in India as per cleanliness survey released by Hardeep Singh, the Minister for Housing and Urban Affairs? It is Indore. Second is Bhopal. Third is Chandigarh. And these are the awards that you need to remember. So just remember 3, 4, like the cleanest big city is Vijayawada in Andhra. Cleanest medium sized city is Mysuru in Karnataka. Cleanest small city is New Delhi Municipal Council area. And the cleanest army cantonment is Delhi. And best performing state is Jharkhand. This is the most important. Which chief minister? He launched 2 things. One is a Krishi Mahabhiyan and the second is Beej Vikas Vahan Rath, to educate the farmer about the government schemes of the state. This was launched by Nitish Kumar, who is the CM of Bihar. His party is JDU. Which state government has announced to bear the medical expenses of victims in the first 48 hours up to 50,000 rupees? This has been recently announced by the government of Gujarat. And in case you are wondering who is he is the Deputy Chief Minister of Gujarat, Nitin Patel. Who has been appointed as the chairman of Coal India Limited? Super important, because Coal India Limited is one of the biggest companies in India. It is Mr. Anil Kumar Jha. National Center for Disease Control, they have issued high alert across India for Nipah virus. Now, which of the following is the host of the virus? It is bat, fruit bat. And this virus has come to India from Malaysia. Which country has agreed to give India economic and military access to Sabang port? It is Indonesia. Which state government has announced 10% reservation for women in police forces? He's Biplab Kumar Dev. He's the CM of Tripura. Tripura has Rova Wildlife Sanctuary, Gumti Wildlife Sanctuary and Trishna Wildlife Sanctuary. Faraz Langur is the state animal of Tripura. Capital is Agartala. What will be the length of Jojila Tunnel that has been inaugurated by Pradhan Mantri Modi? The length of Jojila Tunnel is 14.2 km. It will connect Srinagar, Kargil and Leh, and it will be India's longest road tunnel. Who has become the first South Asian to be elected in Oregon? What is her name? Her name is Sushila Jaipal. Himachal Pradesh state government has sanctioned 25 crore rupees for renovating the historic British Raj Bentoni Castle Estate. Located where? It is located in Shimla. Shimla is also facing a huge water crisis. As per a study by NASA, which country overuses water and therefore may face a sharp decline in freshwater availability? It is India, and this mission is called GRACE FO. GRACE follow on. India Meteorological Department has recently issued an advisory which states in India, there are 5 states and 1 union territory, they can have a cyclone recently. Which cyclone? It is Cyclone Sagar. And the states are Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, Goa, Maharashtra, and 1 union territory is Lakshadweep. Cyclone Sagar can strike them. And also there was a cyclone Mekunu which struck Oman and Yemen in Middle East. Who has been sworn in as the new Chief Minister of Karnataka? He is H.D. Kumaraswamy. And Deputy Chief Minister will be G. Parameswara. H.D. Kumaraswamy party is Janata Dal Secular. Which state Chief Minister has launched the first phase of a tree plantation drive along Rispana River? It is Trivendra Singh Rawat of Uttarakhand. Which country has launched world's first floating nuclear power plant called Academic Lokomonosov? It is Russia. Vladimir Putin is the president. Which team won the UEFA Europa League and which team won the UEFA Champions League? Champions League is the bigger tournament won by Real Madrid. And Europa League won by Atletico Madrid. Both are from Madrid, Spain. Which institute has developed an arsenic sensor and removal media called ADO Mukto Dhara? They will remove the poisonous arsenic from water. This has been made by IISER Kolkata. Who laid down the foundation stone of National Institute of Disaster Management at a place called Kondapavaluru village in Andhra Pradesh? He is Venkaiah Naidu. He laid down the foundation stone for the same. Which singer won the highest civilian award of Bengal called Banga Bibhushan? Banga Bibhushan was given to 4 people. One is Asha Bhosle, whom you can see in the pic here. Then there is a superstar Proshanjit Chatterjee. Then retired Justice Shamal Kumar Sen and writer Samaresh Majumdar. The first Bastaria battalion, it has been commissioned into the service to curb Naxalism. This battalion will work under which force? It will work under Central Reserve Police Force. Indian Army recently concluded their Gandhi Vijay exercise in which state? This was done in Rajasthan. Which state government has launched Nidan software for monitoring the non-communicable disease like diabetes, heart attack and all that? It has been done recently again by Rajasthan. When was Anti-Terrorism Day celebrated? This is to commemorate the 27th death anniversary of former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, who was killed in 1991 by LTTE. It was May the 21st. Which country has become the first in Southeast Asia to eliminate trachoma? Trachoma is a disease of the eyes. It is eliminated by India also, but they are asking Southeast country. India is not Southeast, so it is Nepal. India has eliminated trachoma and also a disease called Rinderpest. Rinderpest has been eliminated from India. It is a disease of the cattle. Pradhan Mantri Modi launched Kishan Ganga project. What is the capacity? Capacity is 330 megawatt. It is on Kishan Ganga river in Bandipol district in Jammu Kashmir. Kishan Ganga is a tributary of Jhelum river. Who has become the youngest Indian woman to climb Mount Everest? She is from Hisar in Haryana. She is Shivangi Pathak, only 16 years old. Who has become the first Sikh to be appointed as a cabinet minister in Malaysia? What is his name? His name is Gobind Singh Deo. New Development Bank, also called BRICS Bank, headed by KV Kamath, headquartered in Shanghai. They have opened their first America regional office where? They have launched it in Brazil. And the first regional office in Africa was opened in South Africa in Johannesburg. Home Minister Rajnath Singh has announced to set up a special force to combat Naxalism in India called Black Panther in which state? Black Panther force will be work in Chhattisgarh. Also remember, Black Panther is the name of a movie also which was screened in Saudi Arabia after 35 years. 13th India-Nepal Joint Military Exercise Surya Kiran will be taking place where? It will be in Pithoragarh in Uttarakhand. Who has been robbed by Niti Aayog for promoting Bheem app and for promoting women entrepreneurship? He will be the brand ambassador for Women Entrepreneurship Forum. He is the great actor Sushant Singh Rajput. As per Energy Efficiency Services Limited, which is carrying out Ujala scheme, Unnat Jyoti for affordable LEDs for all, in which we want to replace 770 million bulbs in India with the LED bulb. How many bulbs have already been distributed? 30 crore bulbs have been distributed. Who has been awarded the Man Booker Prize for her book called Flights? Man Booker Prize is given for best work in English across the world. She is Olga Tokarczuk, and Olga Tokarczuk is from Poland. Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, she received the all-woman crew of INSV Tarini who went for Navika Sagar Parikrama headed by Vartika Joshi, Lieutenant Commander Vartika Joshi. Where did they return? They returned to Panji. they left from Panji in Goa, then they went to Australia, to New Zealand, then to Falkland Island, then to Cape Town, then to Mauritius, they came back to Goa. Which state chief minister has announced to launch Chhatra Parivahan Suraksha Yojana for the safety of girl student? Basically, he is saying that, no girl should travel more than 10 km for getting education. So this has been done by Haryana. Which city hosted the first informal summit between India and Russia? It was hosted in Sochi between Pradhan Mantri Modi and Vladimir Putin. And the first informal summit between India and China took place in Wuhan in China. Arunachal Pradesh's first commercial flight landed where? It landed at Pasighat Airport. And Pema Khandu, you can see him standing here. Pema Khandu is the CM. Union government has approved an ordinance to set up India's first national sports university at which place? India's first national sports university will be set up in Manipur in Imphal. Which country is going to conduct a joint operation with India to control wildlife poaching? It will be done by Nepal. And from Indian side, it will be done in the Uttar Pradesh Wildlife Sanctuary, which is in Krishnapur. So this was the video. Finally, I brought it. It was a little late, I think by 2 or 3 days, but nonetheless, I put the same effort in Hindi and English videos. So do share the video with the people from South, Northeast especially, who prefer to watch the videos in English language. And if you like the video, please like, comment, subscribe our channel. Almost 50% of the views come from non-subscribers, so still there is a lot of scope for subscription of our channel. Do like, comment, and please share the video with your friends also. And before I wind off, I want to remind you about our pen drive courses. We have pen drive courses for all of these exams which are mentioned on the screen. If you want to buy any of the course, go to studyiq.com. Thank you so much for watching.